So we all go to restaurants, right?
Yeah.
And we all have our choice of restaurants. Sometimes we go to small ones around the corner. Sometimes we go to the very big ones. Sometimes even to 5 stars. Yes, absolutely. So you sometimes go to the 5 star because you want to see a beautiful view. But after you go to the restaurant, what do we look at? We have a menu, right? A menu card. And we look through all the items. And finally, before ordering, what do? We shortlist on a few items and finally order 1, 2, 3 items, right? We are very specific about what we order. So the same thing we are going to talk about today is the cosmic kitchen. See, there we are talking about the kitchen where the actual food is being cooked. Today we are going to talk about the cosmic kitchen, which is nothing else but the universe, right? The universe which is there waiting for your orders. So similar to a restaurant where the waiter is waiting for your orders, the universe is also waiting for your orders. Unfortunately, we don't give the orders in the correct manner. Like suppose if we tell the waiter that I don't know what I want, just bring anything. Is the waiter going to bring something? Or he may just bring something which we don't want. Okay? Or if we are not clear, same thing is going to happen. We have to be very specific and clear about what we are ordering, right? Same thing happens with the universe. When we are not clear about what we want, we unfortunately get the wrong results. Sometimes we just get the wrong results. So today we are going to talk about that how to order from the cosmic kitchen anything that you wish to order. Okay? And this is specifically based on a book called Ordering from the Cosmic Kitchen by Dr. Patricia Crane. And she was one of my teachers where I did my Heal Your Life leadership workshop training. So she's actually been trained under Louis Hay herself for several years. And cosmic kitchen is the universe, which is where, you know, everything is being cooked, right? So there are certain principles that we have to follow, and those are the principles that I'm going to share with you today about ordering anything that we wish to order. And sometimes, you know, why things don't work in spite of us ordering, you know, in the right manner. So we're going to go through some of these principles of ordering anything which we wish to order from the universe. Okay. So I'm just going to write them down here. So the first step, like I said, you know, when we go to the restaurant, it is very, very important to know what you want. I mean, unless you're not clear about which dish you want, you're going to end up with something wrong. So the first principle, can you see the color?
Yes.
I'll use a darker one. So the first one is very important, which is decide what you want. Yes.
Writing something on a video, when we see it on the YouTube, nothing which we can figure out.
Okay.
By the time to write.
Okay.
Connection is gone. Now, you pull it forward.
The board, you say?
The board can be brought.
Okay. Can you pause it and then it's. So we need to be very clear about what specifically we want. See, sometimes what we do is we talk about things that we don't want. Now that's a problem because the universe also takes that as an order that this is what I want. Okay. For example, if I'm in a job and I don't like the job, I say I don't want to be in this job because it is really bad. Okay. And I don't like the job, but the people are not nice. So I say something which is not something which I don't want, but I say something which I want. Sorry, I don't say something that I don't want, I say something which I don't want. Okay. So we need to be very, very clear about what we want, right? After you've decided that, see, and it could be anything, right? It could be in the area of your health, prosperity, relationships. Anything, a relationship is not working, you would want that relationship to improve, then you can say, I would like to share a wonderful relationship with a particular person, right? Now the second thing in this whole process is that the orders need to be in the present tense. We are really talking about what is known as affirmations, if everybody knows affirmations, right? Present tense, they need to be positive. And thirdly, they need to be personal. Okay? So before we get into this, let's talk a little bit about affirmations. Does everybody understand affirmations?
Yes.
How do you define affirmations?
Personal statement, and like you said, present tense, short, applicable to a user isn't.
Okay. So a personal statement. Okay. A positive statement. Okay.
No ambiguity.
No ambiguity. So they are very clear. Okay. What else?
Emotionally charged,
should be emotionally with feelings. Okay. Now let me redefine affirmations for you. Okay. The real definition of affirmation is that every thought we think and every word we say is an affirmation. Okay. So it could be that if you're thinking something negative, that also is an affirmation. If you say a negative word, that is also an affirmation. So every thought we think and every word we say is an affirmation. The problem is that most of the time we're talking about the problems in our life. Okay, so we're continuously giving out affirmations of what we don't want really. Like suppose I'm having a problem with my health. If I keep saying that my health is not good, I'm having a serious problem with my health, what is the affirmation I'm giving out? It's a negative affirmation. Okay, now the fact is that my health is not good. So it is very natural that I will say my health is not good. But unfortunately, what we're giving out to the cosmic chef is my health is not good, my health is not good. So the cosmic chef will say, okay, so that means that you want to keep your health bad, I will make sure that your health remains bad. Okay, basically, the negative thoughts do not allow our healing energy to release. As a result of which our body does not get healed. Okay. So every thought we think and every word we say is an affirmation. Now it's very hard to control thoughts because thoughts, as you know, are very, very fast, very quick. There are almost 60,000 thoughts on an average that a human being gets, sometimes even 90,000 thoughts. Okay. So what is it best to focus on? Best way to focus on our affirmations are our words. Because words are very slow compared to thoughts. So if we just pay a little attention to what we are saying, then we are going to make sure that we are always affirming the right things. Okay. Now these are affirmations. Aside from, there is something which is known as doing affirmations. Okay. So there is a difference between affirmations and doing affirmations. So what all of you just spoke about earlier is known as doing affirmations. Okay. And what doing affirmations means is to create a statement of something that we want, a positive statement of something that we want. But what most people fail in understanding is this. This affirmation is everything that you say and everything that you think. Now what they do is mostly in the morning and the evening when they're doing their daily rituals, they will say these positive affirmations, and during the entire day they're thinking negative or saying negative. Imagine what's going to happen.
Negativity will overtake.
Obviously, because most of the time you're thinking something different of what you don't want. Okay, so there is a huge difference between affirmations and doing affirmations. Today what the principles that we are talking about are really about doing affirmations or how to actually create statements. But don't forget this aspect because this is very important. You know, even while writing the most beautiful affirmations, and we do those in the morning and evening, throughout the day if you're thinking negative, you're not going to create an atmosphere for those affirmations to grow. Now, affirmation is like a seed in the ground, right? You put a seed in the ground and then you need to provide it the right atmosphere for the seed to grow. You need to make sure there's ample moisture, you're taking care of it, you're watering it regularly so that the seed comes out. Now, what generally happens is you put the seed in and then you don't take care of it. Okay, so generally it doesn't sprout, it doesn't give you the results that we want, right? So today we are talking mostly about doing affirmation, how to create the right affirmations. Yeah. So they definitely need to be positive. They need to be present tense. Present tense means it should say I am something, or I have something, or I receive something. Okay. Say suppose I want to have a salary of say 2 lakhs per month. So what should be my affirmation? I'm earning rupees 2 lakhs a month. That could be an affirmation for the salary, right? Okay, so that is being present. What about positive? Can I say something like, I don't want bad health? No. It doesn't work. So,
my health is perfect.
I am actually enjoying a wonderful, healthy life. Okay? So, it should be positive. And third is, it should be personal. Okay? Though I have also seen, and I have actually experimented, that affirmations do work for other people as well. So, this is contrary to what is mostly said, that affirmations work only for yourself, but they also work for others. Okay? Because affirmation is also like a prayer, you know. You actually close your eyes, you just relax yourself and say something out. So if I say Mr. ABC is getting a good job, it actually works because you're actually sending out a prayer for him. Okay? Right, so that is the second thing. Third thing is, include feeling words. It needs to give out some energy, like you said, you know, the affirmation needs to express some feelings. So you can say something like, I'm so happy and grateful that I have now received this order from this client. So the happy and grateful, the moment you say those words, you get yourself into a higher vibration. You get yourself into a positive feeling. Okay. And it is all about, finally, it's all about the feelings of an individual that attract things into your life. Why is it feelings? Does anybody know? Why feelings? Why does feelings attract the right things into your life? Okay. Feelings, scientifically, if you see, thoughts are the ones which generate the feelings. If you're thinking positive, you're going to generate positive feelings. If you're thinking negative, it's going to generate negative feelings. Very simple. Feelings create vibrations. Okay? At the end of the day, everything is energy. All of us accept that. You are energy, I am energy, this chair is energy, everything is energy. It's only that everything is oscillating at a different frequency. Everything is moving at a different frequency. Correct? So when I am generating certain feelings, okay, it could be positive feelings or it could be negative feelings, I am also vibrating at a certain frequency. So if I am operating at a frequency of joy, of peace, of happiness, yeah, of compassion, what am I going to attract? More of that into my life. If I am going to vibrate at a frequency of sadness, anger, jealousy, greed, dissatisfaction, okay, what am I going to complain? What am I going to attract? More and more negative circumstances into my life. So essentially it's the vibrations. So it's basically law of vibration, or you can call it same thing as law of attraction. Yeah, so when you vibrate at a certain speed, you're going to attract everything that is in harmony with the speed. So if it is negative, you're going to attract things which are negative in negative harmony. Okay? So that is why it is critical to create the feeling words, because if you say, oh, I am making so much money, but you have no feeling, what in a sense you are telling the universe is that I am making money, but I am not, probably I don't deserve it, or probably, you know, I am not worth it, or I doubt it that I will make so much money. But when you are actually experiencing it, that, you know, my monthly income is so much, I am so happy and grateful that my monthly income is so much, what is it that you are giving to the universe, saying that, yes, this is the amount of money I want to make, and you are actually experiencing the feelings. So it is necessary to actually bring the feelings when you are saying the affirmations. Okay. Then the fourth thing is, trust the timing of delivery. Okay, let go of the timeline. Now, when you are ordering something in the kitchen, in a restaurant, obviously all different plates will take different time. If you've ordered a very complicated dish, it's going to take a lot of time to bring all the ingredients together and prepare the dish. Some dishes may come very quickly. It all depends on what you're ordering. If you're ordering something which is complex in nature, which needs to bring a lot of things together, you need to trust the timing. Okay, you just need to leave it to the chef. You know, we're not going to go again and again into the kitchen and try to find out, like, why is it my order not coming? When we order, we're going to sit and relax and wait for the order, trusting the chef on whatever he tries to do. In between, the waiter may even come and say that this particular dish is not available. But at least you know that they are trying to do their best. Correct? So that sense of trust is very important. Now, when we say an affirmation, but we don't trust that it is going to happen, if internally there is a little voice which says, who are you fooling? Then it doesn't work. Like, suppose I say my income has tripled, or my business, I want to go increase my business to threefold, or my business is already so much turnover, and inside there is a voice saying, who are you fooling? That's not going to be possible. Then you are not trusting the process, as a result of which that order is not going to be executed. Okay, there is a mistrust component, or there is a fear. So remember that while you are giving out your actual order, you are also giving out fear. And when you are giving out fear, that order is not going to get executed. Okay. Right, so letting go of the timeline is very, very important. Just let it, you know, just leave it. Just say it and leave it. That's it. Yeah? And let it happen. Okay, I'm just going to erase this. Put one more. Okay. Let the chef decide how the order would be fulfilled. You can't tell the chef that you cook the food this way. Correct? Sometimes what we do is we ask for things and then we start outlining, oh, this is how I'm going to achieve the goal. So we should leave the the decision on how the order will be fulfilled to the chef.
You mean the process, you should not have
only the end result in the outcome. The reason is then you are closing the other doors. You know, there may be multiple paths to reaching the destination. If you're selecting one path, then what is the role of the chef? There's no role. So it is better to leave it open so that it will select the best path to the destination. It's always just better to open it up. Okay. So that is, let the chef decide how the order would be fulfilled. Okay. So don't do the outlining, don't decide, how to, cook the dish. Let the chef decide how that dish would be cooked, right? Okay. The sixth point is balance between action and allowing. See, what happens is we've given the order. Now there is a tendency to work very hard on it. Okay? And when we are working very, very hard on something, what are we bringing in? We are bringing in a lot of anxiety in that. Okay? We are bringing in stress, we are bringing in anxiety. As a result of which, it becomes counterproductive. So sometimes you have to just let go. Okay? So there is a fine balance between action and allowing. So sometimes when you're trying to do some action and you feel that things are not working out, it is best to just let go, just release. And this you can find out by seeking inner guidance, you know. You can maybe sometimes meditate and just ask yourself whether this action is appropriate or not. If you feel this action is not appropriate, just let go and leave it to the universe.
Means you take action, and if you are stuck up in something, then you...
Not stuck up. You know, you feel that something is not right. Just let go at that point. So there is very fine balance. Like, you know, it's very hard to say when to let go and when to take action. But that is something that you need to do to by just taking inner guidance. Inner guidance you can get by going into meditation and just asking yourself that, you know, do I really need to take this action or should I just let go? Sometimes the orders just get fulfilled just like that. It's like, suppose you're looking for a better job. You're in a particular job and you're looking for a better job. You know, one action you could take is keep searching websites, keep making phone calls, keep talking to people. Right? Because we are always taught that action is results. Right? Even I used to keep saying that, without action, no results. Okay? But I realized over a period of time that you have to have a fine balance between action and allowing. Sometimes you just have to allow. Just let the order be fulfilled. Okay? And you start seeing things happening on their own. Like suddenly somebody calls you and says, you know, this opportunity is available. Suddenly some, you know, you're reading the newspaper and some opportunity comes across. It just happens. Okay? So everybody understands between the difference between action and allowing. Okay? That's again something which is slightly different from what we do generally. Seventh point is believe that you deserve. To have a wonderful life. Sometimes it's just a belief issue. That internally we just don't believe that we deserve a good life. Okay? Because this is what we were taught when we were very young. That we don't deserve this. You know, this is the good lives are not for us. We need to work hard to make money, to do whatever. So internally somehow that belief is not there. Okay? If the belief is not there, unfortunately, things will not happen. The trust factor has to be there. The belief absolutely needs to be there. Yeah? Otherwise, it doesn't happen. So believe, everybody, in reality, everybody deserves a wonderful life. There is nobody in this universe who doesn't deserve a wonderful life. But it's only what we believe, something that we've caught in our childhood, that holds us back from receiving and achieving and allowing those things into our life, right? The seventh and eighth and the most important part is to feel the gratitude. Feel the gratitude to the universe for fulfilling the orders. Because the universe will keep fulfilling the orders in small ways, different ways. And we always need to be in the thankful state. If we're not in the thankful state, what's going to happen? We're going to end up complaining. When we are complaining, we're again basically asking for more reasons to be complaining. Okay? So following all these eight principles, if we form our affirmations, you know, we are likely to make sure that those orders will get fulfilled. So let's take a few examples. Okay, how do we create affirmations? Any examples you want to take on creating affirmations? Anybody wants to solve a problem and we want to write an affirmation for that?
Relationship,
okay. Improving a relationship, okay. So, pardon me?
This is the most difficult aspect of everybody. Be it your junior, senior,
and achieving some goal.
Right.
Financial or career.
Right. So, let's take an example of, you know, a relationship that we were looking at improving. Correct. So let's say we are looking at improving a relationship between two people. And so I've already decided what I want. My goal is that I want to improve my relationship with this person. Correct. And I need to frame an affirmation which will take care of this. Right. So what could be a good affirmation? First of all, I need to bring in some energetic feelings, you know, something which brings in a lot of you know, positive feelings in my statement. So can I say something like, I'm so happy and grateful that I now share continuously happy relationship or harmonious relationship with this person. Okay.
And I enjoy the
whatever you want to add. But you know, first thing is add something which you're saying they're very happy and grateful about, you know, happy and grateful that I now share a wonderful relationship with this person. Okay. Now, does that solve the problem? See, it is one is writing the affirmation. What's the experience? Why does it not solve the problem?
Over a period of time, again there is a strenuous actions and all this thing. And then slowly you forget the affirmation.
No, sir, what the reason it doesn't work is the same thing I said. There's a difference between doing affirmations and affirmations. And this is what I have seen as failing with most people. And I think it's good to talk about it a little bit because that's where affirmations don't work. Okay? We create this beautiful affirmation saying, I'm so happy and grateful that I'm sharing a wonderful relationship with this person, right? I've made the affirmation. Now, what are the ways of doing the affirmation? Let's talk about it. How do you do the affirmations?
Consciously, after the affirmation.
No, I have written this affirmation. Now, how am I going to say this affirmation?
If that person comes, consciously take action to see his intention. I mean, whatever happens, I mean.
No. My question is, how are we going to use this affirmation? First of all, we are going to speak it out. So, like you said, one way is we keep speaking it out. Correct?
Morning and at the time of day.
Morning and evening. That's the best time. First thing in the morning, just before going to sleep. Loudly. Okay? Try to speak it out loudly as and when possible. In front of the mirror. Okay? That's another way. Very powerful way. Looking eye to eye in the mirror and talking out the affirmation. Then another way of doing affirmations is writing them. Okay, if you write it 21 times a day, at least for 21 days, that also gives you an impact. Another way is to listen to the affirmations. Like suppose you can record it in your voice and maybe record it 21 times and keep listening to them. Okay, but the most important thing is that when you are saying out these affirmations, the feelings are very, very important. Okay. So, the feelings and the belief, and you visualize it also, yes, combine it with visualization, that you're saying the affirmations and you're visualizing those things happening in your life. Okay. Now the key is, you do this in the morning and you do this in the night. What about the 10 hours that have gone in between?
Even the day also, when you have a chance, you have to keep repeating in your mind.
Okay, if you can keep doing that, great. But suppose you are a busy person.
So when you are traveling, you get 2 minutes again, waiting for the bus, in the bus.
Okay.
So it's something like that is going to be pounding for your brain.
It has to be part and parcel of you. But it has to be very light.
Yeah.
See, the thing is, it has to be very light. When you say the affirmation, it has to be said as if you don't hold the thing too tight.
Enjoy.
Okay, just relax, just enjoy, and just lightly say it.
If you do not get the required result, maybe you will get into depression if you are doing it.
You have to get the result. Every seed that is put in the ground has to come out. The reason it does not come out is the same reason that during the day, if some challenges happen with this person, all of a sudden what will happen is, you will say, oh, my affirmations don't work. Okay. Again, you start thinking negative. You start, you know, getting into, maybe if there's a quarrel or something, you get into a quarrel. What happened now? All of a sudden your thoughts have gone haywire. The moment your thoughts go haywire, you're sending out affirmations which are way too powerful than what you have done in the morning and evening. Okay? So it cancels out all the effects of all the other work that you have done. So what is most important is that during the day, the first step I would suggest to everybody is to train our language, our words. Every word we say, we need to notice our words. Because to control thoughts is going to be a hard process, and we need to train our thoughts to get to that level. It happens after some time. But initially, the first thing we have to be careful about is the words we say. Okay? So, if the relationship is tough, you know, you're still going to say in your mind, you know, you can't say that to the person, "Arey, ye to sunta hi nahi, this is not happening, that is not happening, you know, the person just doesn't want to listen to me, I do so many good things, the person this. Okay? Now what are we doing? We are making affirmations which are way too powerful, because now your emotions are so powerful. When you do the positive affirmations, your emotions are not that powerful. Okay? Now here, the affirmations are very emotional, very strong. The result for that comes out instantly. Okay? So that is why we say that sometimes we get into this thing that affirmations don't work. Now, even saying the statement, affirmations don't work, is an affirmation. The moment you say that affirmations don't work, done. You've given another order saying, don't make my affirmations work. Okay? So the key is to keep watching our words.
Body language is very
important. Body language, everything will fall into place. The simplest thing to control is the words. It's the easiest that I have noticed, because you can hear what you're saying and it's not so fast. Okay? So once you get in the habit of catching yourself and saying, oh, what did I just say? And just cancel it. Say cancel, cancel. And replace those words with something positive immediately. Okay? That's something that works beautifully. You just quickly cancel and replace it with something positive. And keep following this for several days until your words are always in harmony with what you want. Not only in the morning and evening, it doesn't work.
Throughout the day,
every single thought, every single word needs to be in alignment with what you want. And you don't have to stress yourself out of because of that. You don't have to do that. It is a gentle process. Be very gentle on yourself, you know. You don't need to be very hard on yourself, because the moment you're too hard on yourself, you'll keep criticizing yourself. Okay? You'll keep judging and criticizing yourself, and once you do that, what are you giving out to the universe? Judgment and criticism. So what can you expect back? Judgment and criticism, nothing else. So it needs to be a very gentle and, you know, slow process. It need not be like overnight process. But this is something that I have found working beautifully in my life. Okay. So in spite of the situation, see, the challenge is, in spite of the situation in front of you, you need to be able to talk the words of the things that you want. That's what will turn around the situation. What generally happens is, as soon as the situation changes, the words change, the thoughts change, okay? And instantly your affirmations go for a toss. So that is something that, you know, I want to share with you, because this works beautifully.
How much time it takes for the English?
Nobody knows. It all depends. If you ask for a cup of coffee, you probably get it in 5 minutes.
From your experience, sir.
Yes. It actually manifests pretty quickly. The end result may take time because it depends on the size of the goal. Correct? But things start happening. Like suppose I have a goal of increasing my business, my work. I want to reach out to more people. That means somehow, you know, I need to be able to attract those people into my life, right? So when you do these things with the right way, all of a sudden you find people coming into your life wanting to help you, wanting to do things.
Definitely you are going in the right direction.
That shows that you are on the right track. If things are not moving at all, that means something is not going right. Something is not going right. Correct.
Now, a case that boss doesn't listen to you, whatever you say, you want to do explanation and all this. The same thing happens after the affirmation. At that time, this inner dialogue or self-dialogue, what to improve?
We need to basically be in complete control. That the boss is, you know, suppose he gets upset, and obviously that is bound to make you upset internally. That is the point where we need to control ourselves.
Means what kind of
now the control?
Situation has happened.
Now yes, situation has happened. The self-talk is going to be exactly the same affirmation that we're going to say. My boss is really good. He just listens to me. And the amazing thing is that in spite of that, if you keep saying that, now your boss will start behaving in a different manner. It is just that cut-off point that we need to wait until.
Before that emotion deepens, of whatever happened, you have to correct.
Again, correct it. Instantly correct yourself. Yes. And that's the challenge which most people face.
In spite of the negative thing happening, you have to still keep saying the positive. That's what I mean.
That is the challenge everywhere. That is why things don't work.
So, at times it may mean that you are not realistic or you are away from the truth.
But see, if the goal, yes, but if
you are my boss and there are some groups, you know, so one group is trying to, you know,